Hello everyone, welcome to this interview series where we have another computer science graduate from TU Delft. She did computer science in the same batch when I was doing computer science in TU Delft from 2015 to 2017. And her name is Aditi. So I will leave to Aditi to give a brief background about her and then we'll start with the interview. So off to you, Aditi.
Hi, I'm Aditi. I did, as he said, the computer science along with him in the same batch in from TU Delft. After that, I found a job here in Netherlands itself in TomTom, which is a navigation company. Before coming to TU Delft for my master's, I did my graduation. My BTech from India in Kanpur, from HBTU Kanpur. And I did not have any work experience before my master's. So directly after my bachelor's, I came for my master's. And then I got my first job here in Netherlands. And so far, I'm really liking it. So I'll be here helping Sambit answer a few questions for that you might have while applying for computer science jobs in Netherlands.
Okay, so let's start with the first question on the, and the focus of this video is only for applying for computer science jobs in Netherlands. And in the next video, we are going to discuss about what Aditi is currently working on. So if you want to see what she's working on, which is that she's a data engineer in TomTom, so then check the next video, which will be in the info card. And for this video, let's start with the first question. So what was your experience of applying for computer science jobs in Netherlands? I know it's a very broad question, but you can like sum up maybe in brief, like what is your overall experience? And then we can go in the details slowly.
Yeah. The thing is, so while applying for a computer science job, if you are a graduate from TU Delft, it's actually mixed approach. For me and for many students, it's people prefer, for example, in the market here, people, if you say you're a graduate from TU Delft, they take you like seriously, okay, that she brings some information, some knowledge onto the table, and hence it becomes a little more easier while applying. So it's not like you apply, you have campus fairs or anything, or like job companies come to the university. It's not like that. But however, in TU Delft, in our time, there was, for example, some fairs and some companies which actually came to the university. But it was not like what we usually have in India and what we are used to. It's quite different. It's more like just a company came and used the premises of the university, but you have to apply on your own. And you have to search for the prospective companies that might suit your profile. You have to apply for yourself, write your own CVs and apply. It's a ongoing process and long prone process. It's not an easy thing that you apply for, just maybe start applying and you immediately get a job. It's definitely not like that. You have to try and try and try and try hard. It might take longer, depends on luck as well. But in general, I think the average is around 3 months, if I'm not wrong, for computer science graduate in Netherlands, that you would get a job within 3 months. So you have to try hard and change the CVs, for example, and cover letters every time you apply for a different position. But also you have to be really, for example, spot on your technical knowledge. Although it's maybe if you compare with the kind of interviews that happen in India, it's a very different experience. You are required to be precise on your basics here. But if you, for example, do not know an answer, you can say that you do not know and you will learn. They also appreciate that answer. I think further we will discuss more about the process itself. But in general, I think the experiences, my personal experience was good. I learned a lot for during the number of interviews that I gave. And then eventually when I got the job, it was, it was a good experience.
Okay. So as you said, like it, on an average, it takes like 3 months to get a job. So how much time in your case did you need to prepare for this entire process, like the job search, job application? And one more question to add to it, like what are the basic requirements that one should keep in mind while doing job search, during the search and after the search, I mean, in the interview or something?
During your master thesis, for example, the last semester of your studies, you should start getting into that zone of applying jobs. You need to apply for it. You need to be very serious about it. You need to dedicate some proper time to it. And for example, every day, see if there are new jobs coming in on platforms, if there are more some vacancies here and there. Try to search if there are new companies. Keep searching for it. You should prepare your CV quite in advance. So for like, I was due to graduate around in August. So I started preparing and making my CV in shape in around February, March. Also because we had a career fair in our university. So prepared our CVs for that. For that purpose. And but honestly speaking, I got serious about applying jobs in around May, because that is when you actually know that when you will graduate, because companies require that information. If you're approaching a company, you need to tell them that I will be available from this time on. So this is one thing that you should know before applying a job, and you need to be certain. Okay, 15, 20 days here and there, it's fine. You can communicate to the companies, but something around, it's not like you think you'll graduate in August, but actually your thesis gets delayed and you'll graduate in December. This is not appreciated. Once you have an idea, okay, I would graduate, and I think I would graduate around end of August or September or October. That's what you communicate, and that's when you try to anticipate when you should start applying. So ideally, if you are about, for example, to graduate in, for example, October, or you should start looking in June, for example. But also it's like slowly, steadily. Initial days are like you're learning yourself. Try understand, okay, what's out there? Do I need to change my CV? You start communicating. You start trying people. It's not like your first communication will arrive within days. It might take 3 weeks for a LinkedIn message that you might have sent, and you get a message back. So that process needs to start and keep rolling. And after job search, it's and also you need to keep in mind, because you as Indian students, non-EU students, you need a visa. So you need to apply to only those companies which actually sponsor visa. That is one thing that you need to make sure. And after you get a job, it depends on what company you've got a job, and the what you need to do depends on what are their requirements. If there's some particular skill that you lack and they require, you should, while the time you get between after graduating and joining, you should try and catch up on that. But apart from that, it's easy. It's not that hard on. You need to take it easy. Go with the flow and take it sportingly. Yeah, also because during the end days of your thesis, it's very, you need to dedicate more time to your thesis. And it's like, because you're writing your thesis, you're a lot of time and your energy goes into that. So before, when you are actually experimenting, you're doing your low phase in thesis, you should start anticipating and preparing for this, so that at that time, it's not like really problematic for you.
Okay, that's a very good tip for everyone out there who's watching. And so let's go to the next question. Do internships or previous work experience help when you are applying for computer science jobs in Netherlands?
Yes. So, apart from your master's knowledge that you gain, previous work experience also matters. Also, because in your CV, they say, okay, if you've done a certain project or if you've done worked in a certain environment which is different from the current one, you have the possibility to apply for those jobs as well, apart from directly what you were studying, for example, in core of your master's. So the prospects of applying the kind of jobs you can apply for, the range widens if you have a previous work experience. Internships also matter. If you're doing, for example, internship here in Netherlands itself, you have a very high chance of getting, for example, an offer from them. So that is something. So if you and also, for example, if you're doing an industrial thesis, then it also it's like okay, 80% chance that you might get a job there. Or you network out. So if you do, so there are two things. So if you have done prior work in India, for example, or somewhere before masters you're working, so that counts because in Netherlands your the salary structure is based on the work experience. So if you're a fresher, you get a certain amount. There's a barricading. There's a limit that you can get. And based on the number of experiences you have, there's a minimum amount that you ought to get. So if you have work experience, you will start from that job based on Dutch laws. So that is something that will benefit you while getting your first job as well. Yeah, and if you are doing an internship in Netherlands itself, then of course your work experience and the exposure that you get and what you learned matters during the interview process. So it's, of course, it's beneficial if you have something. But if you do not have, it's also not a problem because for me myself, I did not do any job before. I was a fresher, direct from bachelor's, direct from master's. And internship as such, there was no major internship that I did. Something here and there. I did a TA in the university and I did a part-time job during my master thesis. But there was not much to offer, but based on my knowledge and based on my interest and everything, I got the job here. So you benefit from something, but it's not like if you do not do, you lose too much. One door closes, another opens. That goes on.
Okay, so as you said, like depending on the experience, you have different salary brackets which increase with experience. So can you throw some light on what are the typical salary ranges that a fresher can get or experienced internationals can expect in Netherlands in computer science?
I think the starting is around 40 K annually gross.
Gross, yeah.
Gross. So that is, I think, if you're an absolute fresher, that is something around that range. You would get something. Could be 41, 42, 43, could be 39, 38, but average is 40, I think.
So roughly, how much will it be? Like very roughly, how much will it be on hand after you pay tax per month? Very roughly, I know
Very
that tax
roughly.
is very.
It would be, I think, around 2000, I think, or 1800 or 2000, something like that,
Per month,
per month in hand.
or maybe a bit more. I mean,
Maybe a bit.
based on what I know, I think I'm not sure, but I think it will be around 2200 or 300, something like that.
Maybe something like that.
Yeah.
Around that range, and also it depends. For example, based on, for example, 40 might be a base. You might have some bonus as well, and then it combines and into. But something around maybe 2100, 2200 in hand per month, roughly.
For the experienced ones.
For the experienced ones, I would say 45. 44, 45, 46, around 45, I would say, for 1.5, 2 years of experience. If you have a prior job, then your starting would be around, I think, 45, 46, at least, based on the
Okay.
same knowledge.
I think, like, I mean, we are just giving you an idea, but you can have it online or maybe check in Glassdoor or somewhere. I don't know which are the authentic sources, but you can have a look in Google. So let's move to the next question. So how aligned do you think the computer science coursework and the thesis was with respect to your job application? So in short, like, was your study experience really helpful in TU Delft when you were applying for jobs in computer science or when you're working in those companies?
Short answer is yes. but in so the kind of studies, because you study various courses, so you you are open to, for example, apply for jobs that belong to certain course. You like, for example, computer science, there are plenty of, for example, just plain software development jobs. Software developer, junior, associate, mid-senior, based on your skills and knowledge and your experience. There are a lot of, if you fare enough in a particular language, for example, Java, Scala, Python, C#, there are multiple jobs for your specifications. And it depends on, I would say, the kind of coursework and the pattern that they follow at TU Delft, that's quite industry oriented, and it's because it's up to the date. In TU Delft, the for example, the assignments, research work that's happening is what's actually there, really being developed and research being done at the moment in the industry itself. So hence you are up to the date based on the technologies and everything. So it helps a lot while applying the job. So you are up to date with the technologies.
I can also relate to that. Like, I mean, not the job part, but like what you are taught in TU Delft is really like in line with the current industrial and research publications. So it gives you a really very good benefit and edge when you are applying for jobs. This question I get many times. I try to answer them, but it will be better if you give your own perspective so that people will know it much better. Like, do you need any Dutch in any point of the job application pipeline for computer science?
For me, no. I did not need Dutch at any point of time. At this point of time, it's been 5 years now in Netherlands, and I've survived without Dutch very easily. Yes, while applying for jobs, in some of the companies did require or did say, if you know Dutch, it would have been like, for example, the companies, for example, the Indian companies like Accenture, Cognizant, Capgemini, these, because they deal with clients in Netherlands, hence they prefer people who know Dutch. So I approached them from the idea, okay, it's Indian companies, they might hire for Indian students. But they directly said, no, we need Dutch-speaking people. Because, and it makes sense, because they here in Netherlands, they are dealing with Dutch clients. So, but also, like, for example, it depends on if you're applying for consultancy kind of role, a little senior level role, then you need... you might prefer for certain companies, you need... It's not mandatory. You can go away without Dutch very easily, because there are ample of opportunities in the market for computer science students. It's not like if there are 10 jobs which require Dutch, there are 40 out there which do not require Dutch. So it's always good to learn the language. However, I'm the bad person who says that, because I haven't learned the language, you can go away without learning Dutch for computer science specifically, because it's more of a desk job, and for code writing you do not need Dutch.
So let's move to the next question. What are the common websites that help a lot for computer science jobs in Netherlands? Maybe you can speak them, and we'll leave it in the description below, like the links.
Yeah.
So that you can look over it, and also we will leave your contact in the description below, whatever you want to share, LinkedIn or email, that people can contact you if they have any questions about applying.
Sure. So basically here in Netherlands, on the Dutch websites, the government websites, you have a list of companies which are registered in Netherlands. So you can go through the whole list of all the companies that are here and choose for yourself which is in your area and which is not in area. Basically, the problem here is there's no, for example, you have iimjobs, internshala, or those, or Monster, or those kind of websites in India. These exactly same kind of websites do not exist here. So you have to go to company's website, see their career page, and apply there directly. Although there are possibilities from TU Delft itself, because companies, there is a job department, career department in TU Delft. So there they get vacancies from different companies, and you get to know, okay, which ones have vacancies. And while, for example, the career fair that we had, there were a number of companies that came in, and then you got to know which companies have possibilities. For me, LinkedIn was the most useful tool because you could reach out to recruiters directly. I took premium account of for LinkedIn while applying for my job. So that's something that really benefited me. And I would recommend people to do not choose for saving few monies, but buy the premium LinkedIn account before starting your while you start searching for a job, because it really helps reaching out to recruiters, and you get fast replies, you get noticed earlier. So you can stop once you get a job, but you can stop that premium account. But it's really beneficial. I benefited a lot. I got my job using LinkedIn Premium. So that's one thing. Apart from that, majorly it's you need to know which companies you want to target, and then go to their websites and search from them. Or you have, for example, brochures. Like for example, there was one Bosch, or there was company brochure. There in general job fairs here as well, organized by the municipalities of Netherlands, different cities. Their brochures also lists, for example, the companies that are joining in. You can apply, you can join those job fairs and see which, and apply, give your CVs to them and apply through them. So that's all possibility.
Okay. Did you ever use the websites like Indeed or Untouchables? I have heard from few people. I don't know how useful are they, like.
I did not use them, so I don't know.
Okay. So let's move to the next question. What are the biggest challenges that you faced when you are applying for the jobs in computer science in Netherlands?
Biggest challenges is the so based on the job profile that you're applying for, you need to be technically sound for that. And whatever you have written in your CV, you need to know each and every word of it, because that is something where it is culturally different from India. In India, you write certain things. For example, you write big terms in CVs. Okay, I know, just for example, XML and Java and Python and Spark and C Sharp and C++. You write all these terms to increase, maybe in your first year, you did a small 1 week project on C++, and you write that C++ in your CV as well. But when you are applying, you present your CV here, they can ask you anything. And what they, if you've written something, they expect you that you know every bit and like basics of it at least. So you need to make sure what you write in your CV, because you need to be confident enough to answer each and every question which comes on that topic, at least the basics of it. So if you apply, for example, I am aware of this environment, could be IntelliJ IDEA, could be Eclipse, NetBeans. So they can ask you, okay, what was your experience with this software? So if you use that tool 5 years ago, then and you can't answer that question, it gives a bad impression to the interviewer. So that is something was a big challenge, because coming from Indian background and the universities in India, how they teach you to write a CV and how you should actually write a CV based on the on what they expect here, that was something that I had to learn from experience And then get my CV right after one and two applications because it was not selected. Or interviews, I got stuck in, for example, something that I wrote and I had worked 3 years ago on this. At that time, I knew everything about it. For example, PHP. I had done projects on it in my bachelor's, but after finishing my master's, I had forgotten about it. In one interview during my starting days, I got stuck in it. And then I realized, okay, I need to remove these terms which I'm not aware of. I mean, I might know something, but, and also they're not beneficial for the job you're applying here. So why to add these things? The simpler your CV, the more precise your CV, the better it is.
Yeah. I mean, that is completely true because whenever you're applying for any jobs, try to adapt your generic CV to those specific, as you said, like the position requirements or something. So you already mentioned about this. So now we are going to talk about it, like the career fair. So each university where we study, they have a career fair. And also you mentioned now that the municipalities have also career fairs.
Yeah.
So obviously they help in finding or maybe knowing about companies. So what was your experience? Like you got to know about like four companies and then you kind of applied for that after a few months or kept in touch with them. Like what was your experience of joining, going to a career fair?
So these career fairs are useful for networking. So it's not like you will get a job in at a career fair. It's hardly any chance that you end up that way. It's on more like you exchange numbers, you exchange LinkedIn contacts, and your for example cards, visiting cards. From the companies that are there. And also, for example, when you go to a booth in a job fair, you talk to the recruiter over there. Maybe you strike a chord and you talk about something in general. They ask for a CV. Okay, it gets recorded in the database. And also, you take the LinkedIn contact. So LinkedIn contact is the key. And their cards, for example, so that at least you have either email addresses. Phone numbers are not preferable because it's like getting too personal. So that's something you should not, you refrain from asking for. But email address and LinkedIn contacts, something you should definitely ask for. And the more contacts you generate during job fairs, the more successful your visit is. So that is the key. And then you have to, for example, after the job fair, immediately, you should send them emails or send them thank you notes from LinkedIn contacts, messages that it was great meeting you. And let's see if you have any, that you keep the communication channel open. That's the key. And then if you see, for example, on a particular, for a company, you see there was a job vacancy that popped up. You dig into that LinkedIn contact for that company and try to go through that process. So that is something that helps in these job fairs. Also you get to know, for example, there might be companies you think are not in your sphere. For example, could be NS, the train company here. You think it's a train company, it's not in your for computer science. But while, for example, at job fairs, you see they actually are working a lot on AI, on machine learning, because they're trying to revolutionize the train networks here. So they need machine learning data science engineers. So you do not know about it, and you thought it was not in your for computer science, but it's actually for computer science as well also. So in that perspective, also job fairs are helpful. But number one is networking. Number two is getting to know. And also number three is practicing. Because you pitch in, you give the pitch of yourself. You try to sell yourself. Okay, I'm this, I've done this, and hence I'm beneficial for this role in your company. How I would benefit. So it's good for your public speaking skills and practicing as well. So, I mean, one should never shy away from attending these jobs if you have a possibility, because you always benefit something out of the other.
Okay, so what are some of the well-known companies that one can apply for computer science jobs, like in general, because obviously people will be looking out for their interest, but in general, like?
There are many. computer science is like booming here. There are a lot of startups, established companies. There's Philips, ASML, there's, of course, TomTom, my company. There's Booking.com, Bol.com. And I mean, this is just 3-4 of them, but there's what do you say? A lot of like startups. There was Access for there was a 3D printer startup that I once applied for. It was an interesting job startup that they were doing, and they had to convert all of their C++ code into Java, and they needed a Java developer for that. So it was interesting. There was a lot of semantic analysis and business-oriented companies, small startups. In Netherlands, actually, currently, there's a lot of startup culture going on, and startups which are established. So maybe 50, 60, or 100 large startups. So there are a number of them. And large companies, of course, the established ones, you have... Shell is although Shell also had a young engineering program for computer science a little bit, but it's not like the main company, mainstream company for computer science, but also you have a certain opportunities there. A lot of Philips, Excel, if you just search on Google computer science companies, there are plenty of them,
or maybe in LinkedIn, right?
Or maybe in LinkedIn, yes.
And one additional question, like, because when, I mean, although I'm doing a PhD now, but I was also applying as a backup for some jobs when I was applying for PhD. So I think you also applied, I don't remember, but the traineeships, like there are many traineeships. Can you like say in one or two lines, like what are they and are they really useful or not? Like,
I think I applied for Philips traineeship, if I remember correctly. They train for a certain period of time, and then if you fare well, they hire you for a permanent job. They are also okay in the sense that you get to learn a lot on that front. But it depends on if you are in a situation that you need a job, and you don't have other options, it's good to go that on that path as well. But maybe if you just want to get on with the industry, maybe you should look into something else. Traineeships are okay, but maybe for someone who has experience or worked before should not go for traineeship programs. Someone who's fresher might think of going into program if they do not have other options available. But also because there are a lot of applicants for traineeship as well, so it's not always easy to get a traineeship. There is a lot of competition as well, and the rounds that you have to clear are too many. And they hire just maybe two or three trainees. That's it. So, as I said, if you have time and energy and need, you should definitely go for one. But there are other options as well.
Yeah. I mean, for experienced professional, I think they also have a limit, right? Like, I remember it was like 1 year or something. I mean, you should have less than 1 year or
yes,
one
of experience.
Year.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't make any point of teaching someone's like with experience and taking them away from their domain or something like that.
Yeah.
Okay. True. So the interview is already getting long. So let's end the interview with the final question.
Yeah.
Any final advice or tips that you want to give to future computer science students when they're applying for computer science jobs in Netherlands?
Don't worry, you'll get a job. You need to work a little hard, stay focused, and do take LinkedIn Premium. That's the best approach here to find a job. Yeah,
that's very nice. Thank you very much for giving your time for this interview. So if you like this video, then don't forget to smash the like button. Share this video with all your friends so that it reaches to everyone and you can get to know about the computer science jobs in Netherlands, how to apply and all other things surrounding it. Yeah. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed yet. So till next video, where we are going to discuss about Aditi's job, that is data engineer, job interview, experience and everything. Bye from Netherlands.
Bye.